Well, hello everybody and welcome back to the Westwood D1200. This is a very rare vertical shaft diesel twin engine, which yet again I'm having a few issues with. I don't think it's too serious, it's just one injector. It's been opening at the wrong pressure and it's been leaking. I looked into it and it's just far more cost effective to buy a new one because the parts are either unavailable or are very expensive. So yes, I'm just waiting for the new injector to arrive. In the meantime, I'm actually sorting out a deck. Just here we have the old rotten deck from the previous T1200 project that I did. And I've got a new deck which I've just painted up. So essentially all I need to do is transfer all of these parts that I removed from the rotten deck onto the new deck shell. But I'm going to also paint all the orange parts because as you can see they are flaking. They're quite rusty. So they would definitely benefit from a paint, a bit of a cleanup. As for the other parts, they all seem good. There's only two parts that I couldn't salvage, and those are essentially the bearing housings which were underneath. As you can see, these are new old stock. You probably can't get hold of these anymore. Part number 4253. But the ones on top of the deck, because they sort of sandwich either side, they're not too bad. They're a bit rusty, but there's plenty of life left in that. So yeah, it was actually not a bad deck. If it wasn't rotten, it would have been okay. Even the blades are quite good. I'm going to keep the blades for another deck as just a spare pair, but I think probably for this deck, as it's going to be a bit of a restoration, I will fit some new blades. So let's get on with it. That's all the parts painted. I've also applied some new decals. It's now time to reassemble it. Thank you. And there we go, it's done. There's only one part I haven't been able to refit, and it's this one here. I'm just waiting for some quarter of an inch UNF bolts, and then it can be put on, very simple. It's just a belt guide plate. It should work fine without it anyway. But yeah, the good news is the injector has now arrived. I think it came from Germany. Yeah, I believe Lombardini from Italy. But yeah, that must be where the parts are. So that can be fitted. That was £170. Some people will say you should always change them in pairs, in a full set if there's more than two. I think for this particular engine, that is not going to be worthwhile because it is a bit of a novelty engine. It's not going to be used much. It's not like a compact tractor, which I'm using every day. So I think we'll be fine with just the one. And I'm going to keep the old injector for spares. And if I ever do get hold of an injector rebuild kit, I will do a video on it. We'll rebuild it and we'll probably replace the other injector, the top one in this case. And then we should have two good injectors. Although, yeah, I think the top one probably is good, but it would always benefit from a rebuild because I thought the bottom one was good until a few weeks ago. Okay, so yeah, we'll get that done, get it all tidied up in here, and then I'm going to give it a bit of a test drive. We'll cut some grass and see how good it is.